The shipping industry transports around 90% of global trade. All over the world, marine traffic intersects with crucial whale habitat, with vessels killing and injuring these endangered and critical species. Whale experts estimate that thousands of whales are killed globally each year. Here we can see how a cargo ship strikes a humpback whale near the port. This means that some species cannot recover, and in some areas they are highly endangered or nearing extinction. Ship strikes are rarely witnessed, and the distribution of strike risk and estimates of mortality remain uncertain at best. A study conducted by Point Blue Conservation Science shows the endangered marine mammals are being killed at higher rates than is acceptable to keep their populations growing. In some circumstances, ships were unaware of a strike until they enter port. Ship strikes typically injure or kill cetaceans by propeller strikes or blunt trauma. There have been cases when ships come into port with the body of a whale dropped over the bow and the vessel captain has no idea it is there. This is how marine traffic looks like. The ocean has become a highway for ships. And this is how propellers look like. They are gigantic. Collision between vessels and cetaceans is a problem that is increasing on a global scale. Industries such as cruise lines, shipping, oil and gas exploration continue to grow to meet human pressures, and the use of pleasure craft continues to expand. An increase in cetacean collision events is occurring. Global interest in this issue is growing as there is an alarmingly increase in the ship strikes. Understanding when, where, how, and why vessels collide with cetaceans is important in developing appropriate mitigation to reduce these events. We need to create a future where all cetaceans can survive and thrive alongside our global shipping industry. Here are some ideas. Seasonally or permanently shifting shipping lanes away from all identified critical whale habitat, restricting traffic at night when whales are surface feeding, reducing ship speeds, but this is partially effective. Creating and monitoring marine protected areas and areas to be avoided. Try to consume more local instead of imported products. Do you have any ideas on how we can stop these strikes? Please suggest in the comments below.